For the actors who are new to the Tron franchise, can you talk about your first exposure to the original? Did you see it when you were young? Did you discover it as an adult?
I remember when I first saw it going back in 1943. I was very excited.
You were too young to see it.
I was. It came out 2 years before I was born. But it was always part of the culture. I was aware of it because of the video game. It was kind of this cool retro thing that I was aware of because it was just part of the zeitgeist. I don't know. But I just always knew it was cool. Now we made it cooler.
I was 11 when it first came out. Scarily sitting next to me now, thinking you were not the fetus. But when I went to the cinema, my uncle Russell took me to the cinema in Leeds to go and watch it, and it kind of, I was just absolutely blown away. It was that weird, kind of, apart from the phenomenal acting, I can't remember who the actors were, but it was just that look.
Saw the original until I think 2003. Seen it on a laptop overseas somewhere. Al had to show me and say, "You never seen the original Tron? You never seen Tron?" Well, no, I never heard of it. Oh, I did this. So we sat back and watched it. I just thought it was a trip. Well, it was like nothing I'd ever seen before. Especially at that point, it being, you know, 20 years old, it still, you know, played so well.
Question for the filmmakers and writers. It's great to see a Tron sequel that actually brings back Flynn and Alan Bradley. Just curious, why didn't you want to also use the Lori and Yori character?
Our story is a father-son story. It's a story of Sam Flynn in search of his father who disappeared into the Encom mainframe 20 years before. So. When you make a movie, you have to kind of make difficult choices on what you're going to focus on. And for this story, we chose to focus on the story of Sam and Kevin Flynn, as well as the kind of instrumental role of Tron and Ellen Bradley in that story. But the character of played by Sidney Morgan is in the Tron universe, however, just not in this particular story.
Some questions for Joe. How hard was it to update the look and the whole atmosphere of Tron without being retro, but without making the original look too inferior in terms of technology? And how was it working with the 3D?
Well, the work that Steven did with Sidney and Mobius is just phenomenal. For me, I come from a design background. I feel like that's one of the reasons why the film, you can still sit down and watch it today, even though the computer graphics are simple compared to what we're able to do now. The design work is so strong, the imagination is so vivid and vibrant. It transcends kind of time. So it was quite a task, you know, to sit down and start to look at what group of designers I could assemble that I felt were going to kind of be the next generation of those amazing designers. And I had a great time assembling people from the automotive industry, the world of architecture, people outside the film world to all come in and collaborate on this project. And it was such a great foundation there for us to build on. It was a lot of fun kind of evolving those designs and making it feel more photorealistic, more visceral. I wanted the movie to feel like we had been pulled into the computer and we shot it with motion picture cameras on the inside. As far as 3D goes, this film just seems perfectly suited to it. We use the new generation of the fusion camera system developed by James Cameron. We used a newer generation camera. 35, and it just creates such a beautiful image. I'm really happy with the decision to go 3D because it is a lot more work, it does cost more, especially when you do it the way we're doing it, a true 3D movie shot with two cameras, all visual effects are finished for both eyes. It's a really tedious process, but it pays off.